Hello viewers, welcome back to Home Theater Guide. Welcome to the fourth episode of Home Theater Video Basics. Today in our topic we are going to discuss about what is chroma subsampling. And before we heading up this video, I need to say one thing. If you are having one movie file size of 50 to 60 GB and some other person having the same movie file size of 2 to 3 GB, what is the difference in between these two media movie files? And what is the clarity difference in between those? Those will you can identify after watching this video. There are multiple types of chroma subsamplings are available in the market, but in those there are three types of chroma subsampling which are popularly using nowadays. Those were 444, 422, 420 chroma subsampling. Okay, what is chroma? Chroma is meant to be color. And what about brightness? Brightness will called as luma, and chroma will look like this and luma will look like this. You are watching this video, right? If I remove chroma from this video, immediately this video will turns into black and white. If I remove luma from this video, immediately this video will turns into completely black. I mean dark. You cannot able to see anything. Hence, luma is very important. I mean brightness is more important to a chroma. I mean color. So we are not going to touch the luma part on this video. Let's start our video with 444. Let's take a video file and zoom it to its limits. At its limits, you can able to see some boxes, and those boxes will called as pixel blocks. Our chroma subsampling will start from here. First chroma subsample 444. The first number 4 will representing that how many pixel blocks we are going to take. Here the first number is representing that the pixel blocks are 4. It mean 4 horizontal pixel blocks and 4 vertical pixel blocks. In these 4 rows pixel blocks, first 2 rows are dedicated for chroma and the bottom 2 rows are dedicated for luma. Few seconds back we discussed that we are not going to touch luma segment. So we are keeping those as easily and we are going to change the parts of chroma part. And the second number is representing that how many pixel blocks we need to change or we need to modify. And here the number 4 is representing that 4 individual and unique pixel blocks. That means 4 individual and unique colors. No changes occurred. And the third number, again it is a 4. And the third number is representing that how many pixel blocks we need to change on this second row of first column. I mean chroma column. Here the number is representing that 4. So hence 4 individual pixel blocks, that means 4 individual and unique pixel colors. In 444, we didn't change anything, we didn't modify anything, finally we didn't touch anything. Hence it is considered under lossless compression. So we will get 100% clarity. And the second popular chroma subsample is 422. 422. The first number 4 is representing that 4 pixel blocks horizontally and vertically. Bottom 2 for luma and top 2 for chroma. And the second number 2, it is representing that there is only 2 individual pixel blocks in the first row. That means only 2 individual and unique colors have to place on the first 4 pixel blocks. That means rest 2 pixel blocks doesn't have any color. They need to share the colors with their neighbors. So finally those 2 pixel blocks will combine together and form only 2 pixel blocks apart from 4 pixel blocks. And the third number is also 2, same like above. We have only 2 individual and unique pixel blocks will available on the second row and they need to share their color with the next pixel blocks. Hence in 422 we have 4 individual and unique pixel blocks colors. When compared to 444 we have 8 on there, in 422 we have only 4 pixel blocks. Hence here there is a modification happened, here there is a change happened, that's why we need to consider this as a lossy compression. Hence we are going to miss some pixels and some pixel blocks, some pixel colors. Moving on to the next one, third one, 420. 420 means the first number 4 representing that same how many pixel blocks horizontally vertically, same as this. And the second number 2, same like previous one, 2 pixel blocks having the same colors. And the third number 0 representing that there is no color schema on second row of pixel blocks. That means they need to share the color from the top pixel blocks. Hence in 422 we have only 2 pixel blocks. When compared to 444, it is having 8 pixel blocks as 8 individual pixel colors. In 420, we have only 2 pixel blocks as 2 individual colors. Hence, we have lot of changes happened, lot of modifications happened. We need to consider this 420 is lossy compression. We are going to miss so many pixels, that means so many colors, that means so much of clarity. Apart from these three popular chroma subsamples, we have one special chroma subsample which is 44 and 44. And this chroma subsampling is mainly used in Apple codec, I mean .mov format. .mov means QuickTime Media File format. And this special chroma subsample 4444 will representing that it can able to provide transparent image or transparent video. For example, take an image. If we code this image in normal chroma subsample, it will look like this. And if we code this same image on 44 and 44 chroma subsample, immediately this image will turn into transparent image and it can able to match with whatever the image having in the background. Finally, let's compare this 444, 422, 420 clarities. Consider this 444 as 100% clarity. For an example, take this 100% as a 100 MB media file size. And the 422, which can able to provide 4 pixel blocks apart from 8 pixel blocks. So, it can able to provide up to 67 to 68% of video clarity. I mean, for an example, 67 to 68 MB of video file size. And the final one, 420. When compared to 444, 8 pixel blocks, 420 can capable to provide up to 2 pixel blocks. So 50% of clarity was decreased, hence it can able to provide 50% of video clarity. For an example, consider this 4220 50% clarity as 50 MB of media file size. When compared to 100 MB of media file size and 50 MB of media file size, that's up to you to identify the color differences. And this is the major cause which is increasing the media file sizes in real-time environment. I hope you got a good idea what is chroma subsampling. That's it viewers, that's all for today's video. Definitely we will meet in our next video. Until that, keep smiling, have a great day, bye. And do not forget to subscribe my channel for more videos like this.